Hi, beautiful souls. Well, grab your popcorn and get cozy because today we are diving into some seriously spooky territory. While I glam up with my makeup, I'm going to weave a tale about a haunted house and some spine-chilling ghostly encounters. No product talk here. Check the description box for all dates on what I'm using. This is a kickoff of a brand new series on my channel, and I need your input. Do you want me to keep up doing my makeup while I share these eerie stories? Or would you prefer I focus solely on the storytelling? Let me know in the comments. Your feedback means world to me. Now, let's get spooked. Welcome, thriller seekers, on our first episode of History and Spooky Tales. Now, I do have a manuscript that I'm going to check on a couple of times, so sorry for that. But today we are diving into a chilling and mystery history, one of Sweden's most haunted locations, Häringe Castle. Yeah? Prepare yourself for ghostly tales and unexpected phenomena that will, and I promise you, it will send shiver down your spine. But let me first take you on a journey through its storied past. Our tale begins in early 17th century, when an original Häringe castle was built by Gustav Horn. And he was a Swedish military leader and nobleman. The castle was completed in 1657, and its majestic presence quickly became a symbol of power and prestige. Gustav Horn, he was a man of great ambition and vision. Yeah, he designed Häringe Castle not just as a fortress, but as a grand residence fit for a noble nobility. Its architecture was a blend of Renaissance and Baroque styles. It featured ornate facades and grand halls and intricate woodwork. I have some problems pronouncing that word, but you understood what I was saying. The castle's strategic location near the Baltic Sea made it a key defensive stronghold. Yet, it was also a center of cultural and social life. Grand banquets, royal visitors, and lavish parties filled its halls. Häringe Castle became a beacon of Swedish high society. However, like all great stories, during the Great Northern War, in the early 18th centuries, the Häringe Castle faced many challenges. Occupied by foreign troops and caught in crossfire of conflicts, it endured much damage. But Häringe Castle rose from its ashes through restoration and resilience. It was brought back to its former glory. By the late 19th centuries, castle had transformed into a luxurious private residence once again, under ownership of the Wallenberg family, renowned Swedish financiers. The 20th century brought a new chapter for Häringe Castle. It became a hub for innovation and creativity, hosting prominent figures from various fields. Swedish industrialist Axel Winnergren, a key owner during this period, filled the castle with modern art, rare books, and even installed one of the Swedish first private swimming pool. Today, Häringe Castle stands as a testament to the passage of time, blending historical grandeur with modern luxury. It operates as a hotel and conference center, inviting guests from all around the world to experience its rich heritage, stunning beauty. As you walk through its grand hall and experience its beautiful garden, remember that every stone, every painting, and every room has a story to tell. Häringe Castle is not just a building, it's a living chronicle of Sweden's past. Over the centuries, it had many owners and guests, each leaving their mark. But with a history this rich, it's no surprise that some of its past inhabitants might still linger in its halls. One of the most famous ghosts said to haunt Häringe Castle is a white lady. Yeah. They talk about her. Legend has it that she was a former owner of the castle. Heartbroken by the loss of her lover, she wanders the corridors in a flowing white gown, her sorrowful figure occasionally glimpsed by startled guests. Many have reported seeing her ghostly figure near this very portrait. Some say they felt a cold breeze or heard soft sobbing echoing through the halls. She still takes care of the castle. She is said to look after the castle and get annoyed when and speak up when the guests do not behave. She and her husband are buried under a memorial stone near the east wing. Another hotspot for the paranormal activities is the castle's library. Visitors and staff have reported books flying off the shelves and a feeling of being watched. Some believe it's a spirit of a former owner. A bibliophile remains here. Yeah. Unwilling of leaving his precious collection behind. Imagine reading a book and suddenly feel a cold hand, a cold invisible hand on your shoulder. Creepy, right? I would be afraid. Phantom footsteps are common occurrence at Häringe Castle. Late at night, when the castle is quiet, the sound of heavy boots can be heard, echoing, ascending and descending these stairs. But when you go investigate, no one is there. No one. You can hear them, but you can't see them. Some say it's a spirit of a former guard still patrolling the castle long after his death. Others think it might be a soldier from the Great Northern War. They seem determined to keep an eye on the place. The cellar of Häringe Castle is perhaps the most unsettling area. Today, the dungeon is used for hotel rooms, but before it was used for storage, and before that, some say it temporarily was used for detention center for villains and bandits who were caught committing crime on the castle's property. They were locked in a dungeon waiting for sheriff to arrive and take them to a real jail. Yep. They could be there for hours, weeks, waiting for be taken to real jail or court. So they will stay there for weeks until someone comes and picks them up. It's a place where atmosphere feels heavy with the past. Strange noises, cold spots, and occasionally, whispers are often reported there. people can hear somebody whisper. Could it be someone that died there? Or many believe that spirits of those who suffer there in the dark place still linger, their restless energy, making this one of the most haunted spots in the castle. But one thing that I also found that was interesting, that there is a room in the hotel or the castle, there is a room in the Häringe Castle called Gothic Room. Yeah. Which has an old wooden panel, which is from monastery from Scotland. But it said that the wooden panel came with a monk, and he has a favorite chair that he sits in. And that chair is in the Häringe Castle. If you're unlucky, you might trip over his legs. However, he's not seen as evil, and he doesn't want to offend anyone. But the most haunted part of the castle is said to be upper floor on the sea wing. Many who work there are afraid to go there alone or by themselves, as they feel like watched. They feel that somebody's watching them. Ooh, creepy. There, among many things, a small child is seen walking. It's said to be Gustav Horn's son, Axel, who froze to death when he was just 2 years old. And several guests, guys, this is creepy, several guests, when they go to bed and try to sleep, they can feel, but they said they felt him. They felt him crawling into the bed, perhaps to warm himself, who knows. Some people have heard children crying. There you have it. The spooky stories of Häringe Castle in Sweden. From white lady to phantom footsteps, this place is a treasure trove of ghostly tales. If you ever get a chance to visit there, keep your eyes and ears open. You may experience something paranormal yourself. Thank you for joining me in this eerie adventure. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more spooky stories from around the world. Until next time, stay curious and stay spooky.